Eh bien, bonjour, bonjour tout le monde. Hello everybody. Today, I think I'm gonna take like what's called a bande dessinée. Like it's like a comic book, not quite, but it's pictures and text, so it's easier to read and digest. When compared to a regular book. So I think what I'm gonna do is that I'm just gonna read the text in French, try to translate it, and if I see something interesting in terms of grammar, I will try to delve on it. So the comic book, la bande dessinée that I chose today is Alix, and this is the first album. Usually, when you talk about bande dessinée and a character or story, there's a bunch of albums, and so this is the first one. So I think I don't know when this was published originally, but it's I'm gonna venture to say it's from the 70s or the 60s, something like that. So it's not new. It's great. Great stories. So this stuff goes back to Roman times. So you also learn history at the same time. So let's go through the pages until we reach the first one with text and, or at least with text. So let's get going. Okay, so I don't know what this is. This is a view of the forum, I guess, in Rome. I don't know. I would guess that's what it is. Yeah, I think so. I think this is the forum in Rome. Okay, next page. Nothing. Next page. Okay, so that's the Alix l'Intrépide. Alix the, I don't know. Intrepid, can you say? Yeah, intrepid. Okay, so that's the first page. So as you can see, that's the way a bande dessinée looks like. So let's go to 100% so that we can see the text. Okay, so there's always some narration, always narration, but otherwise it's mostly dialogues. And what's great about dialogues is that it's going to be probably in the present tense. The narration could be in the present, but most likely it's going to be in the past, like imparfait and passé simple. But not necessarily, it could be all in the present. So I don't know what size I'm gonna do. So yeah, I'm at 50%. I think it's okay. Yeah, I can go to 100% just to read this thing. So let's go to 100% just so I can read it. So let's read this. Donc en 53 avant, so Jésus-Christ. So en 53 avant Jésus-Christ, Rome, gouvernée par le triumvirat César, Pompée, Crassus, envoie ses légions conquérir le monde. So let me try to translate that. In 53 BC, Ro Rome, governed by the, I don't know, it's three people, triumvirate, probably triumvirate, so it's Latin, so it's three people. So Caesar, Pompey, Crassus, envoyé, sends its legions. conquer the world. So far, easy peasy. So this is in the present. So envoi is from, the verb is envoyer, and that's the present, present tense. This is the gouverner, this is the participe passé, the past participle. Okay, so let's continue this time in French. I'm going to read first. Tandis que Pompée reste à Rome, César envahit la Gaule et Crassus enfonce trois colonnes de son armée dans l'ancien empire. You do the, let's call the liaison. So you don't say l'ancien empire, you say l'ancien empire. Chaldéo-assyrien défendu par les Parthes. Parthes. Ok, Parthes. So let's translate. So tandis que is while Pompey stays, so rest is stays, so rester, the tense is present, this is present tense. So while Pompey stays in Rome, Caesar invades, again present tense, the Gaul. The Gaul is the old name for France. And Crassus enfonce. Enfonce is like pushing. Pushing. Like you say enfonce un clou, to push in a nail. So enfonce, twice, three columns. Three columns of his army dans in or into since their movement the old or ancient empire Chaldeo Assyrian, so it's like Persia, Middle East, defended. So this is the past participle of défendre. Past participle, participe passé of défendre. So defended by the part. The part, I don't know how you say that. I don't know, it's like, you know, a people. People, I don't know where they used to live, the part. But you get the idea. So on continue, so we continue in French. Ce jour-là, le général Flavius Marsala, commandant l'aile nord, pénètre dans Khorsabad, la fabuleuse cité. Après un siège trop long à son gré. So let's translate in English. Ce jour-là, that day, the general Flavius Marsala, commanding the, so l'aile is the wing, so the northern wing, enters into Khorsabad. So I don't know where Khorsabad is. Maybe Iran, Iraq, something like that. So the fabulous city. After, or siège. I don't remember. A siège. Hold on, I'm just gonna check my trusted dictionary. I should know this, but un siège. It's a siege. After a siege, too long, so à son gré, according to him, basically. So let me just check what's the official translation. To his liking, yes. à son gré, c'est to his liking. Okay? Okay, so let's go to 50%. So this is that first one. So clearly it's the Persians. I think we can all agree on that. Okay, so now the second one. So this is the second one. So it goes like this. This one, that one, that one, that one, that one. So let's look at that one. Okay, so that's the second one. Okay, so in French. Des nombreux défenseurs de la place forte, il ne reste que des cadavres. Let's translate. So you have to, this is the construction, so of the many defenders of the many defenders of the fortified of the fortified place or fortified city, I guess, place forte of the fortified place. So of the numerous or many defenders, blah blah blah, only cadavers remain. Il ne reste que, it means remain, but it's inverted, the construction is inverted. So il ne reste que des cadavres means only cadavers remain. Second sentence in French, so cette fois les Romains ne trouveront pas de nouveaux esclaves pour leur galère. So cette fois, this time, the Romans, so this is the future tense, and in the negative form, so this time the Romans will not find new slaves for their galère. Galère is a Roman ship, I believe. Let me check. I mean, this term is used actually in French quite often, galère, but it doesn't mean the same thing. Oh, galley. Galley. So the galley is the inside of the ship where the guys would row. But in the current French, in spoken French, it also means une galère, it's a bit slang. It's something that's not good. Like galérer, the verb would mean to work hard, to work like a slave. You know what I'm saying? So it's still used. So galère is galley, the galley. You know, the inside of the ship where they row. That's the galère. Okay, so next. So we just did that one, and here's the emperor right there. So let's, so that's, this one is the next one. So let's go to 100%. Okay, so we are here. So the guys has just entered the city, I guess, that he has just conquered. Okay, so en français, ivre d'orgueil, Marsala s'avance dans la ville muette, suivi par sa légion victorieuse, mais accablé de chaleur. Let's translate. Ivre d'orgueil. Ivre means when you drink too much. So ivre d'orgueil. I've been living in the States too long, and I don't remember the word. I'm just, Yeah, he was drunk, of course. So, ivre d'orgueil would be, I don't know, wild with pride, or filled with pride. Marsala, so savance is comes in, la ville muette, comes in the deaf muette, deaf city. This is the feminine. This is the feminine of muet, which means, let me make sure. No, it's not deaf, it's the other one. Okay, hold on. It's the other one. Mute. So, Marsala s'avance, avancer. It's a better. Hold on. S'avancer. So. By the way, s'avancer, it's a pronominal. It's a con pronominal construction because of SE, s'avancer. To move forward. So Marsala moves forward in the mute city, followed by its legion, its victorious legion, but accablé de chaleur. Accablé. Accablé, overwhelmed, yes. Overwhelmed. So it's the past participle of accablé. Accablé, overwhelmed. But overwhelmed by the heat. Chaleur is heat. So son succès va être connu à Rome. His success is going to be known, participe passé, in Rome. Okay, so let's continue. 50%. Okay, so the next one is here. Okay, so it's here. So let's read. Et déjà, il suppute les honneurs suprêmes, sans se douter qu'un habitant échappé par miracle à la tuerie l'observe. Let's translate. Et déjà, and already, il suppute, I don't know. So I have to look, because I don't remember this one. Il suppute. So the translation of supputer, to calculate, to reckon, to calculate or to reckon. Yeah, I'm not sure what. I am not completely convinced. Il suppute les honneurs suprêmes. Let me check another dictionary if I want. Suppute. Let me try another one. You see? I mean, I'm French and I don't remember this verb. Yeah, the dictionary doesn't have it. Let me try another one. Hold on. I'm going to look at the French dictionary. I was using at the French English, but I want to make sure. Supputer. Yeah, it's to like it's to compute, calculate. So I don't know what exactly this means. So let's move on. So il suppute les honneurs suprêmes. So he, I don't know. So I don't know. Il suppute. So, but les honneurs suprêmes is that the you know, the ultimate or supreme honors. So sans se douter, c'est without realizing, or without thinking that a habitant is the one that lives in the city. So a habitant. It's tough to make a video and think about all this stuff. Habitant is a inhabitant, occupant. So, without thinking that inhabitant that escaped by some miracle, that escaped by some miracle, the tuerie, the killing. Is observing him, so l'observe, l'observe is observing him. L is him, that guy. So somebody else is looking at him. So let's continue. Hola, hola, Nervus. Vite au palais du roi Sargon. Hâte-toi, hâte-toi. So hola is just interjection. Nervus is the name of the guy. Quick to the palace of the king Sargon. Hâte-toi is impératif. Hurry up, so it's imperative second person singular. Okay, so let's continue. Next one. So that's the guy, that's Alix. That's the guy that's looking at him. En français, in French. Comme la troupe s'engage alors dans une ruelle étroite, le jeune esclave qui épie les Romains s'appuie sur une balustrade. So come as the la troupe is the band of guys, la troupe. Troupe, Hollande. Comme la troupe, troupe. The troop. As the troop gets, alors is it then? So then gets into a narrow street. So étroit is the feminine form of étroit, which is narrow. Le jeune esclave, the young slave, qui, who, épie, c'est when you watch somebody without being seen. So let me check that. So épier, the verb is épier. Épier is to spy on. Yeah, of course, to spy on, watch closely. So the young slave who is watching closely the Romans s'appuie sur une balustrade. So s'appuyer. Man. I just want to make sure that my translation is correct. S'appuyer. To lean. Yes. S'appuyer is to lean. So s'appuie. S'appuie. Leans. Leans on. Balustrade is. Balustrade is the. When you have a balcony, the balustrade. So let me check that again. Also, I'm sorry, I have to look at that dictionary all the time. Balustrade, a railing, the handrail. It's a railing, railings, railings, or handrail. Okay, so of course something is gonna happen. So that's this one now. So en français, in French, malgré le danger, il se découvre peu à peu et pour mieux voir encore, il s'agrippe à une tenture. Tenture. So, in, despite or in spite of the danger, he shows himself little by little. Se découvrir is to let people see you. So, yeah, he shows himself little by little and. In order to better see, so mieux is better, voir is see, in order to even, encore, it would be even. So in order to even better see, il s'agrippe. S'agripper is when you grab, grab. He grabs. Tenture is the... like the curtain. So he grabs the curtain. A curtain. So next one. Sont-ils de mon pays? Comment le savoir? So sont-ils, are they from my country? Sont-ils de mon pays? Pays, country. Comment le savoir? How can I know it? How can I know it? Here is infinitive. Infinitive. Savoir. To know. But you would translate how to know. How to know. How to know. Okay, so next one. Okay, so this is the tenture, the curtain. Okay, so next one. Mais sa main pèse dangereusement sur le bord effrité du mur. But his hand weighs dangerously on the bord is the edge. On the edge, effrité. Means it's crumbled on the crumbled edge of the wall. Mur is wall. Okay, so that's his hand, that's the edge of the wall, that's crumbling away. Okay, next one. Soudain, la pierre cède et pour ne pas tomber, le jeune homme se retient à la tenture tandis que plusieurs moellons se détachent. Suddenly, the stone gives, cede, gives. This is all present tense, by the way. And in order not to fall, The Young Man se retient. Okay, hold on. Se retient. Basically, he grabs the curtain in order not to fall. So, se retient. Let me just check, make sure. Retenir, se retenir is the verb, se retenir. So that's a pronominal form. It's to hold on, to hold on. So the young man holds on to the curtain while, tandis que, while, plusieurs moellons. So, moellon is like a, those, that's a moellon, that's a big giant piece of stone. So, while several, let me check the exact translation. It's not a word that you would use every day. It's a rubble stone, a moellon. Rubble, moellon, rubble stone. So, tandis que, while several stones detach themselves or fall, detach themselves, fall. Okay, next one. So, the pieces of stone fall onto the guy. Okay, en français, in French. Par malheur. Les blocs tombent sur le char du général et l'un d'eux atteint Marsala en pleine nuque. Translation. Par malheur. Unfortunately, the blocks fall onto the chariot of the general and one of them hits Marsala on the back of the head, on the back of the head. La nuque is the back of the head. Nuque is the back of the head, okay? Le Romain pousse un cri et s'effondre. The Roman pousse un cri is like yells. So, crier is to yell. Pousse un cri is if you translate literally is to push a cry. So the Roman I don't know, can you say cries? No, it's yells. So if I translate literally, pousse un cri is to pushes one yell. So the Roman yells and s'effondre is to fall down or yeah. Let me check the exact translation of that one. S'effondrer. So this is again a pronominal form. I think in English it's called reflexive form. S'effondre. So s'effondrer, collapse. So the Roman yells and collapses. So let's continue. Affolé par ce tumulte soudain, les chevaux se cabrent et la confusion gagne brusquement toute l'escorte. Affolé. Let me check. It's like frightened, I think. But let's check. Affolé. Panic. Panicked. So panicked. Panicked by this tumult is like a disturbance. So let me check. You learn lots of words when you read comic book in French, because those were written a long time ago, and back then they knew a lot of words. So tumult is a commotion, hubbub. So by this sudden commotion, the horses, or se cabrer is when they hold on, when they raise their front legs. I don't know how to say it. Hold on. Se cabrer, oh yeah. So to rear up, to nose, oh yeah, to rear up. So the horses rear up and the confusion gagner is to win, but here in this case it reaches. Brusquement is suddenly. Toutes les escorts, or the whole escort, or the whole troop, or whatever. Okay. So yeah, I mean, even though this is a comic book, and even if you know French pretty well, you still want to have a dictionary nearby. What's nice about, as I said before, as I was saying before, is that because it's for kids, the narration is in the present tense, which is nice. You don't have to worry about the past. Okay, so next one. Wow, still a lot. There's a lot of text, and that's true for most bandes dessinées. Okay, so mais un centurion lève la tête et découvre le garçon avant qu'il ne se dissimule. But a centurion raises his head and discovers the boy before il ne se dissimule, before he hides himself. Before he hides himself. C'est une agression. Regardez là-haut. So c'est une agression. It's an attack. It's an attack. Watch. So that's imperative. Okay. Watch like an order. Watch. Là-haut means up there. Up there. Watch up there. Okay, next one. Okay, so now they're coming back to the general. So, des ordres sont aussitôt lancés et exécutés pendant qu'un officier se penche sur le corps du général. So, I don't know if he's dead or not. Maybe. So, orders are given right away. Aussitôt is right away. Orders are given right away. Lancer means to throw. So this is okay. Executer means to execute is the same in English. I don't know if you would say apply an order or something. But they are so the orders are given and oh man, sometimes it's tough to find the words. Exécuter. Let me make sure there's another exécuter. Carried out. So orders are given right away and carried out. Pendant, while an officer se pencher, it's like to bend over to look at something, se pencher. Again, I have to look. When you make videos, you lose all sense of, you lose part of your brain. Se pencher, it's like to bend over something. Se pencher, to lean over, yeah. Se pencher is to lean over. So, while an officer leans over the body of the general. Okay. Next one. So here is running, the young boy. Donc, mais sur les terrasses, les soldats ont tôt fait de découvrir le fugitif. But on the terraces, it's like the roofs. Les soldats. Oh man, I don't even know. Soldat. Man, what's going on? Soldat. Maybe let me find it quick. Oh no. Soldier. Man, the soldiers ont tôt fait means ont tôt fait de découvrir le fugitif. It means that they didn't lose any time finding the fugitive. Les soldats ont tôt fait de découvrir le fugitif. Les soldats ont tôt fait de découvrir le fugitif. The soldiers find the fugitive almost right away. I don't know how to translate it exactly. Okay, so let's move on. Par ici, il fuit sous la galerie extérieure. Over here. He flees under the outside gallery, the passage. You see, yeah, he's on the roof. Fine. Okay, so that's the last one, and that's just one page. Après une course épuisante, le jeune esclave est cerné. Puis les légionnaires se rapprochent. Alors l'un d'eux lève son javelot. So after a very after a tiring run. The young slave is cerné means that there's no escape, he's completely surrounded. He's surrounded. Puis then the legionnaires come closer, and then one of them lève comes from lever, present tense, lève, raises is javelot. You say javelot? Let me check if it's the same as in French. Javelot. Javelin, of course. Javelin. So now, here, the last one. Tiens, vermine. Tiens, it's like an interjection almost. It comes from tenir. So it's imperative of tenir. I think it's more like here. Spanish, that would be aki. So vermin is just vermin. It's vermin. Yeah, it's the same thing. Vermin. Okay, so I got to tell you, I thought that it would be very easy to do to read. I mean, the reading is okay. The translation is a pain in the butt, I'll be honest with you. And it's a lot of work, I gotta say, to translate. And it's just one page. So those bandes dessinées usually is like 30, 40 pages. So I'm gonna stop here because okay. So that's the page, and that's the next one. So that's a lot of text. Okay. So each row has four vignettes, and you have four rows. So that's a lot of text. So I'm gonna stop here. I hope you don't mind. Okay, so if you like this kind of content, I mean, I can do some more reading. And I don't know if you need the translation, to be honest, or if you would prefer I spend more time on each vignette and explain the finer grammar points about the text in the vignette. I mean, I can do that. I mean, it's fine. Whatever you need. So, if you like my videos, please like, comment, subscribe. If you have any requests, just put a comment, and I'll try to satisfy your needs in any which way I can. Okay, so I'll see you around. Bye.